Welcome to my channel, everybody. Today I have decided to make a video on QuickBooks job costing. You all know how important job costing is for construction business owners, how much it helps you stay in control of your numbers and know your exact numbers for each job. Many people have been reaching out to me because they don't know their costs for the projects that they're doing, and they don't know the numbers for business as a whole. But today I wanted to mention the job costing, because I feel that the job costing is in the roots of everything you do in your construction business. Every single project you do has to have the cost figured into it. You create your estimate, but then how do you make sure that you're not going overboard on the cost that you estimated? I understand that sometimes change orders comes in, but still you have to allocate every little thing to your project. Everything that is directly affecting your job, your project, goes into project. And you have to know how much money you're spending and compare it constantly to your estimate. Job costing is extremely important, because if you don't know your numbers as a whole, then how do you know if the project was even profitable? And then you look at the business numbers as a business as a whole, and then you're thinking, okay, I haven't paid myself enough. Why did that happen? And then to figure out what has happened throughout the month or the year, you have to look at the numbers. You have to see, let's say, okay, my expenses were too high. The percentage of my expenses was too high. But where did it go wrong? Which project did it go wrong? And that's why you always, always have to calculate your cost. I understand it's extremely time consuming. It's tedious task. And you may say that I'm wearing so many hats, I just cannot continue to allocate everything. I just cannot figure out, here's one example. You have the cost that you pay to your guys to work, but they work on different projects throughout the week, right? But they're on the payroll, so you just send them a payment. You have to differentiate that payment. How much time did they spend on one project? How much time did they spend on another project? You have to allocate that money to each project. I know it takes time, I know it's very difficult, but you have to find that time, because you are the CEO of your company, you are the owner. If you don't do it, hire help, hire somebody who helps you allocate it, find the software that they clock in and clock out at those jobs, but you have to know those costs. Without those costs, you don't know your numbers. With job costing, you can use a lot of software options that is available there. Of course, QuickBooks Online provides some sort of separation that you can use, but things like T-sheets, that's a great example of the software that connects to QuickBooks Online, and you can just have your guys download the app on the phone, and when they show up to the job, all they do is they clock in, they mention what job they're working on, and then they clock out when they go to a different job. This way, this whole information then flows into QuickBooks, and then whoever is helping you with the job costing can separate those costs into the project that it goes to. And then you don't have to really do much of anything else. And when the transaction comes through the bank feed, then you already know that it's allocated and you match it to it. So other software is available, like project management software that you're using. Software like BuilderTrend or CoConstruct, those software that I talk about all the time. One of the great features is that time management for your team. You schedule your work, you have your guys go into the job, and they can clock in and clock out. All of that information is saved in project management software, and then all of that information just flows into QuickBooks. And then your accountant knows as well what's going on. Or you can just keep it on the project management software. Some bookkeepers, like me, for example, I work closely with project management software, and I can just go in and analyze the job with you. We're looking at all of your costs that are already assigned to the jobs. You don't even have to do anything. You just pull up the report that shows estimate versus actual, and you see your numbers. So really, we have a lot of opportunities to use a lot of helpful software to help us track all the costs that are associated with every single job. This way, you know your numbers, and this is our goal with the job costing. As you know, all of your costs for your job costing are mostly separated into direct costs and indirect costs, which is your overhead. With direct costs, you just need to make sure that everything that goes specifically to the job is recorded in the direct costs and cost of goods sold. You have to have your materials there, your labor, your equipment rentals, and any other accounts that are connected to that job. For example, if you travel to that job, you have to travel a long ways to that job, you have to include that cost into direct cost because it's not connected to any other jobs, just this job that you have to do. If you are using meals and entertainment, that's usually an overhead. But if you're using it to feed your guys at the construction site for just that job, then you can assign it to that job. Just make sure that when you have, when you're, for example, using projects in QuickBooks Online, you have to assign all those costs to the job. So basically, on your regular P&L, you would leave meals and entertainment in your overhead, but at the same time, you can still assign it to the job, and then you have all of your numbers right there for that job, and you can use that number to do, let's say you're doing cost plus projects. Those are all the numbers that you can show to your customer. Here's what I've spent for last week or month. And that's already gonna be all the cost will be included. So when it comes to indirect, your overhead, you need to make sure that when you're calculating your markup, you're including the overhead cost into it, because we don't want overhead coming out of your paycheck, right? It's not coming out of your profit. It's coming, you have to charge part of it to your customer. So you have to calculate that and include it into your proposals, into your bids. And also, don't forget about payables. Those bills that you have hanging that you haven't paid for yet, you have to include that as well when you're doing your job costing. There are many ways in QuickBooks Online to track your job costing. The most used ones are project feature, then you have your classes, and also you can track by customer. In my preference, I really enjoy using the feature, the projects feature. It's very easy to see the margins that you're having and see all the transactions that have been assigned to all the accounts. So first, when you go into to have projects show up, you have to be signed up for QuickBooks Online Plus. And then what you do, you go into settings, and then you go into accounts and settings, and you choose to track the projects feature. I think it's called, it's in the advanced tab. So what you do, after it turned out, on the left sidebar, you have the feature called project. You just go in there, you create the whole new project, and then when you have your transactions, let's say, coming through the bank feed, all you do is, when you categorize that transit, let's say it's a job material, you just mentioned there's gonna be a little window that's saying customer project. You just pick the project that it goes to, and that's it. It's that easy. I absolutely love this feature. I do agree that many people are tracking by class. That's not a bad way to go either. If you have to go to settings again, and you have to turn on the classes, so then when you try to categorize transactions, or if you create transactions from scratch, right, a bill or something, then you would be able to mention which class it goes to. Another way to do that is use both projects and classes, sometimes that's very beneficial to do because you create the project that's your project, and then classes would be the different areas that you're doing for this project. For example, demolition, electrical, plumbing. So then when you pull up the whole project, then you have all the classes and what you have spent for each of those classes. And the last but not least very important part of the job costing is you have to check your reports. In QuickBooks Online, you can pull up reports in the project feature that's profitability report for job, and you can even have classes set up to go with that project to see more in detail, or you can create more detail in your chart of accounts. But the most important report, in my opinion, is estimate versus actual, to make sure that your expenses are not running wild, and when they are, you're able to catch it before the project is over. And that's where the project management software comes in. It's extremely helpful to pull up multiple reports out there and see where you stand with each job. You can also do that report from the desktop on QuickBooks. So I definitely recommend check out your reports. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, leave a like or a comment. It really helps other people see this content that may be very helpful.